Hey guys, what's up? Ruben here from the Midnight Garage. So, first up, I want to show you guys our subscriber count, which should be underneath here or here somewhere. I'm not exactly sure, but for the sake of this video, we're just going to pretend like that hasn't happened yet because I want to do a celebration video, but I want to wait until Case and Boyd are back, which should be any day now. But for that video, we want to do a Q&A. So if you guys have any questions for us, it doesn't really matter the subject. If you guys just have some questions, post them in the comments below or post them on Instagram or post them on Facebook. We're going to take a look at any of them. And if they're fun enough or stupid enough, we might answer them in the next video. Anyways, that's everything I wanted to say for now. Roll the intro. First up, let me explain the Panhard bars. So, Panhard bars can be found on the rear of a car with a less complex suspension setup. So, if you have a proper multi-link suspension or a proper double wishbone suspension, you probably won't find a Panhard bar there. But if you have, for example, a solid axle, then you probably will find one. Now, what this does in short is, for example, if you have trailing arms and you have a solid axle, the trailing arms will prevent your wheels from going forwards or backwards. But the Panhard bar will prevent your wheels from going left and right and swaying all over the place. So the Panhard bar is actually a really important piece of suspension when it comes to these cars. But if you lower your car, like I've done, then suddenly the geometrics don't make that much sense anymore, and you need to adjust them slightly.
Right, so first up, let's remove the old Panhard rod, which is bolted to the chassis here, and here. Well, that was easy. And here we have the old one, which is made by Toyota. And let's compare it now to the new one, which is made by gizfab. Well, if we compare these side to side, you can first up see that the gizfab one is a whole lot stronger than the original Toyota one. You can also see that the gizfab model uses better bushings than the Toyota one. And obviously, last but not least, the gizfab Panhard rod is adjustable, whereas the Toyota one isn't. So if you haven't heard of this brand before, let me give you a quick summary. Gizfab is a very small company in the UK. It's run by my good friend Eden Young, and next to these awesome Panhard rods, they also make a lot of custom parts, such as, for example, intakes, exhausts, oil catch cans, and a whole lot more products, mainly for Japanese cars, but also I've seen them make a lot of stuff for Vauxhall. So if you're into custom parts and if you don't want to have the standard stuff that everybody has, well, it's definitely worth checking out their company. Link is in the description. Not sponsored, but I did get some candies when he shipped this over, so maybe slightly bribed. Anyways, let's continue. So I personally like to start with the adjustable arm being just as long as the original arm. So how do I do that? Well, first up, I twist it in completely like this, so it's at its shortest possible position. Then I place it on top of the old one, put a bolt in between there, and then I just adjust it until it's just as long as the original Panhard rod. So let's fast forward a little bit. So right now it's just as long as the original Panhard rod. Usually I would say that you should put some copper compound on here, but gizfab already did that for me, so that's great. And now that I'm done with this, I can start to install it. Now, I did end up having to use the hammer quite a bit to beat it all into place, but that's quite normal if you're used to installing pulley bushes and pulley bushes in your suspension. Now, as always, always use a lot of copper compound when reinstalling everything and torque everything to spec. Now, as for adjusting it, if you make your Panhard bar longer like this, then you will move your wheels more towards the left side of the car. And if you make your Panhard bar shorter like this, then you will move your
wheels more to the right-hand side of the car.
Now, the best way to align your new Panhard rod is not by doing it yourself, but going to a professional alignment store and letting them do it for you. But if you do want to do it yourself, I'm going to tell you real quick on how to do that. Well, first up, you need to drop your car, and then you need to move it forwards and backwards a little bit so that your springs are properly loaded again. And then you need to check in how far your wheels are tucked in, because they need to be tucked in equally on each side. So you need to measure the difference between the edge of your wheel rim and the edge of your wheel arch. And once these are the same, you know you're done aligning it. And probably, if you've lowered it just like me, you need to shorten it slightly. How much? That depends on how much you've lowered the car. And yeah, it depends on a whole lot of different things. But in short, slightly shorter than stock, that's usually the answer. How much? You need to figure that out for yourself.
Once you're done adjusting and you're happy with your setup, make sure that you tighten this bolt properly, because otherwise the whole setup can adjust itself again, and that can lead to some very dangerous situations. So make sure everything's tight and you're good to go.
So yeah, guys, that's it for today. I hope you guys liked it. Leave a like if you did, and hit the subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this. And then hopefully we'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.